You might think that we're in the middle of a science fiction movie. Doors that magically open, liquid lenses that focus by themselves, and prostheses controlled by electric pulses from our brain. All inventions that 50 years ago were only found in futuristic science fiction stories. But what drives people to invent? No one knows this better than the speaker of the European Patent Office, Oswald Schröder.
Personally, I believe that innovation drives the world. Mankind cannot without inventing, innovating, doing things in a better way. And we have got so used to be surrounded by inventions that we do not even realize anymore that they are there.
The source of all inventions is the imagination. You have to imagine something before you can invent it, and the imagination appears to be unlimited. Could we ever have imagined, for example, that not only can we produce a toy with 3D printer, but soon even food? Few things are as exciting as the prospect of what may yet come to be, since everyone has their own vision. I could imagine a scanner for use in the home which checks people for diseases, bacteria and other factors, and then fixes the problem right there and then.
A pill to make us all get along.
One possible invention would be that everyone gets a chip that can be programmed at will and can program cancer away.
A tablet that cures all illnesses. It would be great, of course, to reach the age of 100.
Many people would like to see progress in the field of medical care. The good news is that the researchers all over the world are working hard on these very technologies.
If you cluster all the inventions around the field of health, meaning medical technology, pharma, biotechnology, one has about 15% of all patent applications, more than 20,000, in fact, per year with the European Patent Office. And this clearly demonstrates that inventors are especially focused on human beings, on their well-being and on their health.
Inventions are booming. And for many companies, these are their most important assets. Last year, there were 265,690 patent applications, more than ever before, as confirmed by the president of the European Patent Office, Benoît Battistelli. As in previous years, we have also seen an increase in 2013 of patent applications at the European Patent Office. The increase amounts to between 3 and 4% per year for the past 20 years. The first patents were granted in Venice at the beginning of the 15th century. Since then, technical knowledge has been available to anyone. This often spawns the next invention. Indeed, the wheel had to be invented before the steam engine and then the car were possible.
The patent system can be compared to a snowball. One invention generates the next invention, and this invention might generate another one. It's like a ball, in fact. It rolls and it rolls and it rolls, and building on what the others have done, you can then invent the next generation of a technology.
Example: nanotechnology. We use nanoparticles in everyday items such as clothing or skin creams. But now nanotechnology may be able to help us cure cancer. Belgian-born French scientist Patrick Couvreur has developed a method that uses nanotechnology to precisely target cancer cells. I'm not just a researcher, I am also a pharmacist. And so it has always been my biggest dream to help develop a new drug that can precisely target serious diseases, such as cancer. Another example is biotechnology. Some 5,000 years ago, mankind invented the first biotechnical processes, such as baking bread and preserving food. The process, which took root back then, now has reached its zenith with the deciphering of the human genome. Until recently, reading code in DNA took 13 years and cost 75 million euros. Today, things are very different. The Swedish scientist, Paul Nuren, has developed a new method capable of decoding DNA in less than 2 months and at a price of just 6,000 euros. It is really great to develop something and believe that it has a real use. It is really special to be able to help people or others in their research. With the European Inventor Award, the European Patent Office honors visionaries like Nuren or Couvreur who have made our lives a little bit better. This award is considered the Oscar of technology. The next presentation of the European Inventor Award is coming up in Berlin. The Oscar of Technology will be presented on June the 17th of this year for inventions that are of great use to the general public and have helped create jobs. People often have the impression that the inventor is a different kind of animal, and their inventions are magical. We therefore sought to appeal in particular to young people, to whom we would like to introduce these inventions and their inventors. The presentation of the European Inventor Award casts the limelight on the people behind the inventions. In this way, it is hoped that this might influence some young people to become researchers and ultimately to contribute to technological progress themselves. In this way, fantastic visions may soon become reality. The future is looking up.